Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to share with you my current setup in my A5 rings. Okay, so if you've been following me over on Instagram, then you know I've shared a few sneak peeks of my current setup in my A5 rings. I have tried A5 rings in the past and we have just not gotten along for a few reasons. So you might wanna like sit down and grab some coffee, some tea, because I have some very unpopular opinions about this system. So for 2022, I am going to start off the year in A5 rings. I did recently order this Filofax Stone Original. I absolutely love it. It is pretty much the most neutral planner, aside from a black one, obviously, that I could find out there that I knew I could kind of toss in my bag and not be worried about it getting damaged. Like, you can easily wipe it clean if you wanted to. Now, I will say this. This was kind of hard to find, I'm not gonna lie. I had to go on eBay. There are several retailers who sell planners through eBay that are brand new, so you're not getting something used if you prefer brand new. One of my favorite sellers is called The Right Touch. That's W-R-I-T-E, like writing. They sell lots of Filofax products, and I ordered this one through them. I've probably ordered like 5 or 6 planners from them over the last like 8 or so years. So once again, they did not disappoint. This did come with Filofax inserts. Of course, I immediately tossed all of those things out. I did not need a single thing that came inside this planner. It is a very beautiful color. It's like a light gray. It just works well with what I'm using in here. So let's go ahead and open this up, because guess what? This is still pretty boring, but I will explain. And that's where I actually use the pages in here. I'm not sticking to just using black and white. I am going to use stickers in here. I don't decorate my pockets. I just use this for like pure function. Will I decorate things in the future? Maybe. You know me, I never say never, but for me, this is what's working right now. So in the front pocket here, well, there's like weird pockets in this planner, not gonna lie. The pockets are just weird. So I don't really use them at all. I do have a MoxiLife magnet right here. And then I think, is this cloth and paper? I don't even know. Yes, it is cloth and paper. I don't even remember what box or order it came in. May have come with my dividers, not entirely sure. But I do love cloth and paper dividers like more than anything. They are just so perfect. So I have another MoxiLife bookmark here. All of my dividers are from cloth and paper. Now, I got mine unlabeled. I do use my Brother P-Touch label to label mine, and I get the white unclear labels. And I'll be sure to add everything to my Amazon link for this, because this is by far one of my favorite label makers ever. I've had it for well over 5 years now, and it has worked perfectly for me. So just to kind of give you guys an up close view, I do have some bottom tabs here. I chose to get the top dividers and the side dividers, except I just use my dividers at the bottom. I just feel like that's easier for me because I am using a bookmark up here where my today page is, and I don't want to constantly be grabbing like the wrong thing. So my today bookmark stays up here, and then everything else kind of goes down at the bottom. So my first page is actually a cover page from a cloth and paper subscription box from the month of July. I haven't found something to cover that up with. I might just use whiteout. I just liked the J because obviously my name is Julie. So you can see the back of it has like an insert to it that has to be like majorly covered up. I just haven't gotten to it. So this first section is my inbox section, or basically like a catch-all for a bunch of different lists, you know, things like this, like TV shows and things like that. So this particular insert is from Marianne Cresp. That's her Instagram handle, but I will leave a link to her Etsy shop. She does sell printable inserts in various sizes, but I love the way that she sells her inserts, because she sells them like, even though it said A5 rings, you know, she will give you printables that are for A5 rings that are printed on 8.5 by 11 paper, or you can do like me. I actually purchased A5 paper that is already already cut and punched, because I find that to be incredibly frustrating to cut and measure, punch. I can't. I need to find better things to do with my time. So you can get this pack from Amazon. I've probably only used like 20 pages of it, but you can get it from Amazon. It is 100 GSM, so it's not your typical 120 GSM, but I'm telling you, most of the stuff that I use works just fine on it, and this has been a game changer for setting up my A5 rings, because if I had to continuously print, cut, and punch inserts, I would probably just not stick with this. So the easier that something is, the better it is. So I did get her TV show tracker. I also got her movie tracker. I thought that was pretty cool. Like, we watched Don't Look Up on January 1st. And then we are watching Cobra Kai season 4 currently. So that's where I'm at with that. I will add more things in here. Like, there's also a book tracker in here. I need to add the book that I'm reading for the Moxie Life book club. I haven't decided if I want to print out pictures and just kind of put it like right on top there, or just write the name of the book and keep it very simple. So my next section is goals, and you'll also see I don't have like really cute like divider covers. I don't have any of that. I don't really have a desire to set up this planner in that way at all, because again, I don't want it to be more about it looking so like perfect every single time. I want something that's just usable. So anyway, what I did here is the Moxie Life goal setting system and planner comes like all together, but I took the goal setting, like the beginning part of it, out and moved it into this section so that it's always here. So you have like basically all the instructions, the getting started, you have the life compass assessment, all of that stuff. I need to transfer over what I have in my 6-month book into here. Like I said in my previous like goal setup video, I am probably going to have my goals in multiple places because that works for me. So I have all of this up here in the front, the assessment scoring, you know, the entire guide that comes with the Moxie Life. And then I have a bottom divider here that goes to Club Moxie. So Club Moxie is a membership. It goes a little bit more in depth into goal setting and the Moxie Life system. It's a super awesome community. I believe the doors just closed on joining that, but I set up this area of my planner to kind of put the first guide that they have given us. I've kind of already started on it. So this is the 2021 year-end reflection. It already being like the third when I'm filming this, I probably should have more of this done, but I think I'm about like halfway through, and I was gonna work on the rest of it this week, but there's like a good 10 or 12 pages here, and then there's some notes pages. So that's what I'm gonna do right there. Then going into my plans section, this is where I have the daily Moxie Life system set up for myself. I haven't even put my name on here yet. I thought of making something nicer, I don't know, but I will eventually put my name on here. So I also added another one of Marianne's inserts for 2022, because as you probably know, the Moxie Life system is undated. So I needed something to reference that had dates on it. So this is a like yearly calendar, and it just has a calendar for each month and then a bunch of lines underneath it so that you can plan ahead if you need to. And in this area, I plan on adding like paydays, birthdays, things like that. Just haven't quite gotten to it yet. All right, so then we hop into the first section. I actually only have a month at a time in here just because that's all I could really think of putting in here. I wanted to see what other areas in my planner I was gonna need before I added a ton of daily pages. I'm even considering cutting off the tab because it's just unnecessary, but I do kind of like it. So here I have January. I didn't even really use a kit. I used like leftovers from other kits. I just use a January sticker. I think that's from Planner Kate, some washi and some date covers. Have yet to put my plans in here just yet, but I won't be using like sticker kits or like a whole lot of stickers in here. I'll just kind of be writing things in like paydays, maybe even my videos on here so that I can have it like at a glance, appointments, things like that. So then we get into the monthly goals. Again, I've done this in my 6-month Moxie Life. I just need to transfer them over here. I did do my weekly actions for the week prior. I didn't really do like a reflections because honestly it was like the holidays and I was like, oh, I'm not gonna get to that. So here's like the first week. I loved kind of adding like the pops of colors for the dates, and for that I used my Zig Clean Color dot markers. Now, someone had asked in a previous video if I had the corresponding colors for Moxie Life, and I'm gonna try to pull them out and see if I can't get those colors for you guys, because these, like, I use the pastel ones for other things just because they're fun to use, but I don't use any of them for the color coding to match the Moxie Life. So let me go back to the compass assessment and answer that question for you guys. Let's go back to the goals. And so for the yellow, I do use, I'm sure it's called something else besides yellow, but this is Summer Sun, and that's what I use for the personal. And then this is where it gets kind of tricky, is the orange. There's not really a specific orange for the Zig Clean Color Dots, but I use Island Coral for the orange. And then for the red, I think that I was going to use the salmon color, or you can also use just the regular red, but I liked the salmon color better. I know I had two of a few of them over here. And then of course I am using the Hyacinth for family and relationships, the Splash for health and wellness, and the names are on here somewhere, Blue Bonnet for spiritual and personal growth, and then just the green, which I'm sure it has kiwi, for financial, and then of course the gray, which is somewhere around here, which is actually platinum. That's what I use for physical environment, and that's everything that I use for dot markers to match the Moxie Life system. And of course for the mild liners, they have much closer color matches than the Zig Clean Color Dots do, so those are pretty easy to match, not very difficult. Now these, I would say the orange, the fun and recreation was kind of the hardest thing to match, but these are super fun to use in the Moxie Life daily as well. So as you can see, I used some of these colors to make my own like date dots, if you will, for the weekly view. And then of course in my daily view, some days were like super, super basic, and then other days I just didn't use my planner, like on New Year's Eve. And then Sunday I used it again, but I used like purple dots instead. And I haven't done my weekly reflections yet. It is Monday when I'm filming this, so probably need to do that today. And then I decided to use a freebie kit from Hand Can Plan to kind of, you know, sticker up some of my pages without going too crazy, but I really, really do like it when I can put stickers down. I do have a bookmark in here from Cloth and Paper, and I choose to cut mine just because it's so much easier just to pull it out when I need to. And then when I typically plan my weeks in my daily, I do put the date headers down for the whole week, and then that way it's easier just to pop a post-it note where it needs to go. Again, nothing too complicated. So like I said, I have the entire month in here, and then at the very end you have the monthly reflections. All right, so next up is my business section. And right here I just have like a post-it note on this additional divider for YouTube. And these are just things that I wanted to add. I haven't had a whole lot of time to set this particular section up, but I did print out this insert from Marianne with, it's her list of stuff insert, but I'm using it to track my video production progress, which is something that I've drawn out multiple times, but I got tired of doing that, and her insert was close enough. I didn't care that the label didn't match any of that stuff. I could always cover it with washi if I wanted to, but this works. So now I have my videos listed out for the month of January. I even thought of using this bottom section for possible like reels and Instagram posts, things like that, but now I have a space for that. So I printed a few pages of that. And then the rest is just note pages, because I do need to set up like where I'm gonna put my expenses, my income. Even though I track that on my computer, I do like to write it down as well. All right, next up is my family section. And in here I have meal planning and wellness. I could have made a personal section. I might still move some things around, but we'll get there. Like I said, this is still like a setup in progress. I thought it would be really cool to show you guys what it looks like now, and then kind of like take you along how this system progresses over the months that I use it. So now in this area, I got this idea from Saray over at, is her, I know she changed her handle. It's like I am Saray Bailey. Not totally sure. I'm the worst at remembering people's handles, but I'll put it down below. But She has some amazing setup videos where she has taken apart some of her petite planners and used them in this system. Now, I love this, but there's one caveat. Like, I cannot for the life of me handle rounded edges. I despise them with every fiber of my being. And I wish that Erin Condren would come out. They already sell A5 rings. I see on their website they're starting to come out with other inserts. Like, they need to hurry up with the meal planning and hurry up with the wellness book, because I can't do the rounded corners. I know other people love it and they go ahead and they round everything else out in their planner, but this literally makes my eyes twitch. But I'm using it because I actually like the insert itself, and I'm just kind of holding out hope that they will come out with inserts and that the corners are not rounded so that I can sleep at night. Anyway, so this is how I've been using the book already, but I decided to just grab a new one that I already had, and I just cut it up and punched it and put it in here. It's great. This is actually just this last week. I usually just take this into the grocery store with me. I need to check off everything, but I do cut my pages at the rings so that I can just pop them out like so, and then when I get back in the car or just want to put it back, I can just pop it back into my planner. So that's how that's looking. So I just have like a few weeks, like maybe a month, month and a half worth of those in here. And then I moved on to the wellness section, which I haven't been doing that great at. I will get there. But again, this is another wellness petite planner that's just been cut and punched to fit an A5, because they are truly A5 books, so it's super easy to do. I need to set up this week. Last week being a holiday week, probably not the best week to set this up, but I do, again, love this layout. Just really, really hoping that they come out with inserts for it that are not, again, not rounded. So there is that. And then I have a notes section. It still even has the tabs from like my previous setup that I'm just going to keep a bunch of notes paper in to have as needed in my planner. So can never have enough notes paper. Now, this plastic sleeve thing actually did come with the Filofax, and what I chose to do was to attach a MoxiLife pen loop to it. It does have that 3M adhesive on it, so I know that it's really going to stay, but I like having two pen loops. The Filofax comes with two pen loops. It has one right here, one right here. This one makes absolutely no sense to me, because it's really just going to hit your planner like somewhere right about right in the middle. I can't stand it. So I was like, I'll just put a pen loop here, have one here, and then I can always have my, I typically put my pen just with the clip right here, which is normally much easier than how it's looking right now. But that's how I normally put it in. And then I'll have like a clean color dot marker over here, and they don't seem to have any issues. And then yeah, they just kind of sit like that in there, or I should say more like that. It's a little bit hard to see, but yeah, that's how I keep my pens. And then the pocket back there is just a great pocket to keep extra little stickers and stuff. I haven't had any issues with anything falling out or anything like that, but I love keeping like specifically little icon stickers in my planner with me. And then I don't really keep anything back here. I just don't feel the need to at this point. So yeah, that is where we're at with this current setup. I'm really, really loving it. Again, I don't plan on making this like super decorative or anything like that. I do plan on using, you know, different stickers and things like that. And, you know, just like I'm doing for this current week, because I truly enjoy stickers. And I felt like, again, like I was seeing so many layouts that were just filled with only neutral things, or only things that were the color blush or gray or whatever. And I was just like, I don't want my planner to look like that. And maybe there are other people out there who are wanting to get into A5 rings, but they only ever see planners that are super neutral, and neutral is not your vibe. Like, I've always said this, there's no rules in planning, but it can be really hard to find inspiration when everyone's doing the same exact freaking thing. So here I am in my A5 rings. hoping that it works out. So hope that you guys enjoyed today's just kind of overview of my setup of my A5 rings. I'd love to hear your thoughts down below in the comments, and maybe your thoughts on, you know, being able to find inspiration for different planning systems. I know I can't be the only person who feels that way. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. Hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And if you are already subscribed, make sure you click that red notification bell so that you know when my videos are posted here on YouTube. As always, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, everyone.